Welcome to my new video. Today I will explain XML in general, then I will show you how to use it in UiPath. Let's go.
XML stands for Extensible Markup Language. It's to store and transport data. It is often used for distributing data over the internet. XML can be read by both human and machines. What is the meaning of these three words? Extensible means that you can add new data to your XML file or remove data without having any issues in your existing application. Markup is additional information that is added to a document and enhances its meaning in certain ways. More precisely, they are symbols that can be placed in the text of a document to delimit and label the parts of the document. Language, XML is not a programming language. Programming language consists of grammar rules and its own vocabulary, which is used to create computer programs. These programs are used to perform specific tasks. XML is stored in a text file and is processed by special software that can interpret XML. Here is an example for XML document. It is similar to HTML. But there are some differences between the both. XML is to store and transport the data with focus on what data is. HTML is to display the data with focus on how data looks. Both XML and HTML use tags. But XML tags are not predefined. You can use the tag name as you like, such as customer, date, book, food. The author of the XML document must define the tags and the document structure.
HTML tags are predefined and must be used as they are, such as H1, P, A, table.
What are the advantages of XML? And why we use XML? XML simplifies data sharing and transporting. XML store the data in text format. This enables us to store, share and transport the data in software-hardware independent way. If you want to transport the data from system to another, or if you have an upgrade in your system, your data can be lost or you need long time to do that. With XML you can do that more performant and in a better quality without spending long time on it. How is the XML document structure? XML consists of two parts, prologue and root element. Prologue is optional and contains, for example, the XML version or the character encoding, etc. This should be at the beginning of the XML document, if it exists. Root element is the parent of all other elements. XML must contain only one root element. Root element have different child elements, and each child element could have also child elements. What are the parts of an element? Let's see. Element starts with start tag and ends with end tag. Each element could have attributes and text. As I mentioned before, one element could also contain child elements. Let's now see what is the meaning of each part and how to use it and what is to consider. Start tag consists of three parts, angle bracket, then the tag name, then angle bracket. For example, customer. End tag is the same as start tag. The only difference is that we insert a dash after the first angle bracket. For example, customer. Attribute consists of the following parts, the name, equals, and the value. For example, ID is equal to 1. You can use double quotes or single quotes. The last part of an element is the text. Here you just write the value that you want to save in the element. For example, Daimler. Now which parts are mandatory and which parts are optional for an element? Attribute is optional. This means you can use attribute, but you don't have to use it. You can use more than one attribute for one element. Text is also optional. That means element can be empty. Start tag and end tag are mandatory. Each element should contain start and end tag. But if your element is empty, you can summarize the both tags in one tag, such like this example. This is another example for empty element with attribute. One last thing here, the tag name and start tag and end tag should be written the same, because XML is case sensitive. That means, if you write the tag name so, you should write the end tag name the same like in this example, else you will get an error. Now is the question, if there is any rules for the element name, how should it be written? No, there is no rule how to write the element name, but you can use one of these commonly naming styles. Lowercase, here you write all letters in lowercase. Uppercase, here you write all letters in uppercase. Underscore, if your element contains more than one word, you can use underscore between the words. Pascal case, here you write the first letter of each word in uppercase. Camel case, here you write the first letter of each word in uppercase except the first word. I would prefer to use the Pascal case, but it is your decision, what you want to use. In XML you can also write comments. You can set your comment everywhere in the document as you like. This is an example how to write a comment in XML. The last thing you should know about XML is the parser. We have now our XML document, but how to access, read or edit the data in XML documents? This is the job of parser. Parser is a software library or package that checks an XML document for correctness and converts the document into readable code. These are the most important things about XML. At the end of this video, let's try to write XML document together. I have the following data. We have first customers. In this customers element we have two customers, 1 and 2. Each customer has an ID, name and city. We want to write these data in XML format. How to do this? Let's start step by step. First I will write the prologue. Then we continue with the root element. Root element is customers. This element has no text or attributes. Only child elements. The first child element is customer. We have for this customer three information. We can create an element for each one of these, or we can create an attribute for each one of them, or also we can use attributes and elements. There is no rule when to use element or attribute. But if you want to have a good structured and easy editable XML file, then you have to create an element for each information. Attribute you can use to identify a certain element. In this example we have an ID. This could be an attribute, but the other information can be set as element. So I will write the start tag with the attribute. Then element name with its value. Then element city with its value. So we have all information for this element. We do the same for the second customer element. I am finished and we have our data in XML document. As you can see, we have more than one information in the city element. We can also split this element in two elements, so that we have a better structured XML document. The XML document looks like this. I split the city element in two elements, city name and zip. How to read the data from this document in UiPath using the standard activities or using link queries? You can learn this in the next video. Thanks for watching the video. If you like the video, please don't forget to like, comment and subscribe.